Gesehen? Even burn trees. And the funny thing, this guy too in the video, we will not play it all of it because they might claim a copyright over it. He said that the Prophet, he was protected. The funny is, all of us, we knew that Muhammad died by poison, which a woman, she is a Jewish woman, she bought from Home Depot for rats. So Muhammad, he killed, Muhammad, he raped, Muhammad, he did everything. And then he says to you later, he will say, well, you know what? The Christian, they might say, well, this is against what the verse here is saying. And then he say, well, Moses, he killed 3,000 people. Abdul, stupid idiot. Why you jump to Moses? Do the Christians say that this prophecy is about Moses? You see how stupid, how silly you are. So Moses, he killed 3,000 people. The Quran says that he should kill them all. And who said that this verse or this chapter is about Moses? Why you are mixing things up? So they cannot make it fit with Muhammad. They jump to talk about Moses. So my friends, we made tons of videos refuting those garbage. But as you see, I mean, it's silly. This guy is a child molester. First of all, shouldn't we ask ourselves if he's a prophet? Let us say, and why, by the way, there's an important question when Muslims, they say to you this about Muhammad in the Bible. Tell them where, why Muhammad did not say, open Isaiah 42 and you will see speaking about me. Is this a good question? How come the stupid Muhammad, are you Muslim saying to us, Muhammad is so idiot, so stupid, so donkey, to the point he do not know that Isaiah speak about him, but you Muslim knows? Why Muhammad, when he sat with the Jews and he lived between the Jews, he never said to them, open Isaiah 42. Let us read it together. It's about me. Are we following? So what the Muslims are giving us a message that we need to help our prophet to find himself in the Bible. Our prophet is a certified donkey and he cannot understand. He do not know. We know. The prophet do not know. The prophet is an idiot. He do not know that the Bible is speaking about him. And hold on. You know, they will say to you, no, the Quran says they will find in the book. Shouldn't you say which verse in the book? I mean, what kind of argument to say you will find about me in your book? You didn't say where in the book? And man, the Jewish, they corrupted their book, but they kept only that chapter. That's it. The whole book is corrupted. This chapter is about Muhammad. It's a very silly argument, very stupid. But I want to show you something. I found a video about this guy from this guy. Here, he speak about the satanic verses. And I will show you how Muslims themselves, those who, you know, attack Christianity, they are really our biggest help to make Muslims leave Islam. Go, Abdul.
This will tell me the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, violates Deuteronomy 18:20. So what does Deuteronomy 18...
My friend, your Quran, your prophet is a prophet. He violates everything. He's a child molester. He's a rapist. He's a thief. He went to his own son. He flirted with the wife when the husband was not there and he was sleeping with her already. Your prophet, he worshiped different God. Your prophet, he is a black stone kisser. Your prophet, he pray in different direction. Your prophet, his God have different name. Your prophet, his God is not a spirit. Your prophet have, your prophet God have different nature. So what an idiot. Even the, as long you believe in Isaiah, do you believe in Elohim? Elohim mean gods, don't mean God. Why the God of the Jews, he used the word gods, describing himself? Why your Quran never used the word Elohim? Never heard of it?
In 20 say, it says, but the prophet who presumes to speak a word in my name, which I have not commanded him, or who speaks in the name of other gods, that prophet shall die. Okay? So what are they talking about with this verse? They're talking about the story of the satanic verses, right? Of course, so this was a phrase that was coined by, you know, Scottish Orientalist William Muir. Muslim scholars refer to it as Qissatul Gharaniq or something like that.
Abdul, let me teach you Arabic. Qissatul Gharaniq. Gharaniq. May Allah gharnuq you. Continue.
But as you know, Christian apologists, they love this story.
Yeah, we love it.
They think it's the greatest thing since the Book of Galatians, right?
And the other guy, he loved. The other guy, he loved. Whatever this guy, he said, this guy, he support. Like, wow, love. Oh, you know, he's the Joker, like that, the blonde guy. What a whore.
They think it's the greatest thing since sliced bread at Holy Communion.
So you're making fun of the Holy Communion, you idiot. Isn't it your God who sent 7 sandwiches to Jesus in the Quran? And you have a chapter in the Quran about it. It's called the chapter of the table Al-Ma'idah. Allah himself, he gave a bread to Jesus and his followers. The biggest communion ever. 7 whales, each one of them in a big loaf of a bread.
As the story goes, and there are multiple contradictory versions of the story.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know, when the prophet was in Mecca, he was reciting Surah An-Najm.
Okay.
And he recited Afara'aytum Al-Lat wal-Uzza wa Manat al-Thalithah al-Ukhra. Have you not seen these 3, Al-Lat and Al-Uzza and Manat?
Okay.
These were considered to be goddesses among the pagans. Mm-hmm. And then Satan apparently whispered 2 false verses to the prophet, which he thought were divine revelation. وَتِلْكَ الْغَرَانِيقُ الْعُلْيَا وَإِنَّ شَفَاعَةً
تُلْكُ الْغَرَانِيقُ الْعُلْيَا. This is a scholar, supposedly. تِلْكَ الْغَرَانِيقُ الْعُلْيَا. Hey, Muslim, did you hear it? If a Christian prince is the one who said that, the Muslim, they will make a drama about it. تِلْكَ الْغَرَانِيقُ الْعُلْيَا. العليا العليا يا ايديت العلا العليا You are so cute. I wish I can grow someone like you in my yard, but I don't think that government will allow me. Yeah, continue. Let us see. Satanic verses.
أتهن لترتجى.
The ترتجى.
And eventually the prophet, the Muslims, and all of the idolaters prostrated.
Okay.
Word then spread that the prophet had compromised with the idolaters.
Hey, Abdul, liar. They did not prostrate only. Your prophet, he prostrate with them. Continue.
And everything just sort of got along, but then Gabriel informed the prophet of that, and those verses were removed from the Quran. So that's sort of the basic story. Now, Christians, they point out that this story of the satanic verses, it must be true because it fulfills the criterion of embarrassment, right? Would a Muslim invent the story? Why would a Muslim invent a story that embarrasses the prophet? It must be true. So I personally agree with Imam al-Razi about this story.
Okay. What he said?
Imam al-Razi, he said that this story not only clashes with the Quran and the Sunnah, but also clashes with reason.
You stupid idiot. How it's going to clash from the Quran? If you just say it, Allah will remove it. If it's not true. By the way, the Razi is the one who support your prophet about the sperm is coming from when your prophet, he says that chapter 86, verse number 6 and 7, it says the sperm come from the backbone of the man and the ribs of the women. A Razi, he support your prophet and he claim that the sperm of the man is coming from his brain. And the reason, because the cells of the brain look like a baby. You choose a Razi, you idiot. I mean, from all the donkeys in the world, you could not find somebody except a Razi. But look what happened. He said, he speak like he don't believe in this story, but the Quran confirmed the story. He said that the Quran have a clashes with it, but the Quran saying Allah will remove it. So if Allah, why Allah will remove something is not there? This is not the verse, hold on. Why Allah will remove, sorry, I clicked at the wrong one. Why Allah will remove something? Even the Quran says, Shaitan, he throw in his vanity a desire. The verse says that. And this guy is saying, he said, this is not true. Oh boy. This is not true, brother. The story here, it's not true. But the Quran confirmed it. The Quran confirmed that Muhammad, he received satanic verses. Otherwise, why the Quran saying so? And not only that, the Quran saying clearly that Shaitan throw it, Allah will take it off. And now I challenge you to tell me what Allah take off or took off. And what is our guarantee that this verse itself is not made by Shaitan? Because if Shaitan was able to put satanic verses in the mouth of Muhammad, he can put this one too. This guy, he said in the beginning of his video that Allah, he protected Muhammad. Asimuka. Allah, he said, I protect you. But as you see, he did not. Because protection will not happen after the disaster. Did Allah protect him from Shaitan? Did Allah protect Muhammad from the poison? Were the women, she poisoned Muhammad by Home Depot poison for rats? So when he said Allah protected Muhammad and he promised him, that additional proof that this is a fraud. This is a fraud. Now when he go and he say, this is why Ar-Razi, so you know, Ar-Razi is your witness. And Ar-Razi, he said, this is conflict the Quran. Shouldn't you give us why? Why it conflict the Quran? How it can conflict the Quran when the Quran say clearly that Allah will take what Shaitan he throw? Very embarrassing, very silly, and very deceiving. Do we have any Muslim want to say anything? Anyone? And if we go to Ar-Razi, and this is Ar-Razi in the front of us, it says here that when the Prophet was reciting the chapter of An-Najm, when Najmu Ida Hawa, and here we need to ask ourselves, what kind of God he swear by God, he swear by a star. And since whence the stars fell down where? In the earth. So the silly Muhammad, because he is extremely silly, claiming that God is speaking, he made a stupid mistake again as usual. Because simply stars don't fall down on the earth. This is a meteor. And Muhammad, he think it's a star. In the top of that, as long we are talking about pagan and believers, is it this is a proof that Allah is Muhammad the pagan? Because why Allah will swear by a star? You see, Always we swear by something. If somebody want to take an oath, you take an oath by something higher than you, more important than you, extremely valuable for you. But a God, he swear by a star. Why? And actually, if we read this chapter here, you will see this chapter is a disaster, proving again that Isaiah cannot be about such a stupid prophet. Why? Because this prophet, he claimed that Allah, he said to him, Allah, he said to him, by the star I swear when it goes down. Why Allah need to swear by the stars to confirm something? And then he says, your companion neither astray nor being misled. Who is this companion? Muhammad? But this verse is coming to Muhammad. Why Allah saying your companion if he's talking to Muhammad? Nor does he say aught but his own desire. So Muhammad don't speak anything except from his desire. But we just heard him saying that Muhammad, he received satanic verses. The same chapter, you know, you see the Muslims, by the way, when we see this chapter here, doesn't mean that this chapter, all of it came together, you know, but the Muslim, they claim things, which is very funny. If you go to, there's a website show you something called Quran according to Revelation. So you will see that the Muslim, they say to you, this verse came here, this verse came there, and then the Muslim, they added to the book it wherever they want. This is why the Quran is mixed up. But if you continue here with me reading, when it says that this is nothing but inspiration, but Muhammad never received inspiration. Muhammad, he received delivery. Inspiration, if God inspire me in my head, not if somebody come to my door and squeeze me three times. That is not inspiration. That is Amazon delivery. So even the words Muhammad, he is using, proving that he is an idiot. He is not even good in Arabic. His sentence is broken and the meaning is so stupid. Obviously, Muhammad do not know what inspiration means, at least in the value or the standard of belief. Because if you believe that inspiration, that it is somebody delivering to you, literally to your house, by coming to you as a man, and that is inspiration, that is stupid. That will be called, maybe I can say, this is a revelation. God, he revealed to Muhammad something through his angel. I will let it go. But this is not inspiration. I can say I was inspired by this person, which means he gave me ideas. But he did not come to me and tell me to do this and that. So as long as he received a squeezing machine, his name is Jibreel, he came to him as a grandizer. He squeezed him a trade time, and Muhammad do not know why, and Muslim do not know why, because why you are squeezing the guy who do not know what the point? And why you are saying to him, read, if the guy cannot read? Who is the stupid here, the angel or Allah or Muhammad? One of them is a stupid. I say the three. Because if I say to a person who cannot read, read, that is stupid, unless I want to do a miracle. Like Jesus said to the one who cannot see, see, he saw. The one who cannot walk, he walk. He said to him, walk. Allah said to Muhammad, read. Did he read? No. Add to that, and to this, and this, and this, he continues saying, he was taught by the mighty in power. You see, the Muslim, they say that they believe in one God. Correct? This is what they say. They believe in one God. But Muhammad was not taught by Allah. He was taught by a person. He is one mighty in power. Who is that? Who is a Muslim want to help us? Any Muslim? He was taught by who? By one mighty in power. Is that Allah? If the Muslim, they say this is Jibreel, so Muhammad was not taught by Allah. And the inspiration is not from Allah. That means Jibreel is God. Then he continues saying, endued with wisdom, for he appeared. Okay, hold on, hold on. Allah praising Jibreel now? Or he is speaking about God? Who is this guy who is, you know, full of wisdom? He is so strong. He is a mighty in power. And then it says, while he was in the highest part of the horizon, like, what the heck? Who's this? And then it says, and then he approached and come closer. Like, what the heck? Listen carefully. The one who taught him, he taught him when he was in the horizon, and he is a mighty in power, and he is full of wisdom. So why he's getting closer now? He taught him already. Based on this, Muhammad been taught the Quran before anyone come to him, regardless if this person is God or angel. It says that he taught him by one mighty in power. By the way, this is a translation saying by one mighty in power, but doesn't say that in Arabic. It says Allamahu shadidul quwa. The one who taught him is the mighty in power. It doesn't say the one. The one who taught him is the one with mighty in power. Or he been taught by the mighty of power person. And then he approached him. Okay. And then he was a distance, two bow length or even nearer. So the story of Muhammad being squeezed by Jibreel is a lie. Because this is not to bow barrier, you know, distance. Muhammad lied in his story, because as you see, he did not touch him. He was close. And then what happened? And look at the disaster. You see, the Muslim, they said, between two brackets, so Allah, it doesn't say that in Arabic. So he did convey the inspiration. And why they have to add the word Allah here? Because it says here, to his servant. That will make Jibreel Allah. Because Muhammad, servant of who? By the way, the word servant here is not accurate. Abdahu is not just a servant. Abdahu is his slave. So he convey the inspiration to his slave. If this is Jibreel, that means Muhammad is a slave of Jibreel. All right, John, we pray to your brother-in-law to be fine. We pray. So you see, guys, how stupid this religion is. Did Allah come down to Muhammad? The Muslim, they will say no. Do the verse say Allah convey the inspiration to his servant? No. It says, so he did continue what happened. He closed the distance, and now it's time to deliver. Why you insert Allah here? Unless this is Allah. Very silly, very stupid religion. And if we continue, you know, watching the videos, you will see that every single word they say is just a joke. Muhammad, not only he worshiped different God, Muhammad is a satanic messenger. The Quran proved that. And you know, when the Quran confirmed that even Shaitan is an employee to Allah, and he is not a bad person, and Shaitan is a Muslim. Actually, even Muhammad, he confirmed that he received his command from the devil. Even Muhammad, he confirmed that he is a person who received the command, not from God, but from the devil. Read carefully, and this is Sahih Muslim. Focus with me, people. Don't ask me about why Muhammad hates dogs now, because this is not our topic. Are you suffering from flight of thought like Muhammad? Focus, focus. Be mature, adult. And we know why Muhammad he hates dogs, because dogs hate him. Dogs can, you know, can sense evil. But focus with me. Muhammad, he says, there's none among you, but he have attached to him a shaitan, a devil. The Muslim, they will say to you, it doesn't say shaitan here. No, it does. Here we go. Let me show you. We just move a little bit. The mischief of shaitan. They say it. The mischief of shaitan. Okay, what shaitan he do? How he send his troops, what the heck, to tempt people, and every person there is a qareen. What qareen mean? A companion. So according to Islam, every person he have a boyfriend, and his boyfriend is a shaitan. Muhammad, he said, I have a boyfriend, he's a shaitan too. And he do what shaitan do. And they said to him, and you do have to? He said, yes, but Allah helped me against him, so I am saved from his hand, and he does not command me but for good. So Muhammad received command from who? Muslims. Muhammad received commands from who? It's in the front of your eyes, the devil. So when the Bible speaks about prophets, prophet should not receive command from the devil, shall not speak in his name, shall not worship him, shall not follow him, shall not do what he do. Everything Muhammad did is a devilish, satanic. Not only he received satanic verses, this is the lowest to talk about. What about Muhammad, the good man, the wonderful man, making a chapter in the Quran saying any Muslim woman, she can offer her vagina to the prophet so he can if it. Isn't this devilish? Is it really from God he made verses saying any woman, she want to offer herself to the prophet? Are you saying to me that Muhammad is a man who don't care for himself, but he care for his penis? Are you saying to me that Muhammad is very humble, but not when it's come to his penis? He want every woman to sleep with him? Even he said that Allah, he promised him to have sex with Mary, the mother of Jesus. This is how faith he is. Even he said that he is going to have sex with the wife of the Pharaoh. Even the wife of the Pharaoh is not safe from his hand. When Khadija, she was dying, Muhammad, he said to Khadija, look how faithy he is. I mean, the wife is dying, and look what he's talking to her. He said to her, don't forget to say shalom, salam alaikum, send my greeting to my wives. Khadija, she said, what the heck? You married women before me? You did not tell me. Muhammad, he said, I forgot to tell you, Allah will marry me, Mary, the mother of Jesus, and the sister of Moses, and the wife of the Pharaoh. And for sure, he said the sister of Moses, which is Mary, the mother of Jesus, because the idiot, he think that Mary, the mother of Jesus, is the sister of Aaron. So we are so glad that Muslims are trying to find their Muhammad in our book, because obviously their book is stupid. You see, when somebody says to me, Muhammad here, Muhammad there, Muhammad is everywhere, my friend. Muhammad in the cartoon too. When you say that Allah protected Muhammad, here we go, we are making a mockery of an idiot. Where is the protection? The whole world is laughing at him. When we go in the Quran and we find that the prophet of God, he say the most stupid, silly things, and he claimed that this is from God, then we right away will find out that he cannot be from God. I mean, what kind of a prophet he claimed that Zulqarnain, Alexander the Great, is a prophet of Allah? who found the way of the sunset. He found even the sitting place of the sun. The Jewish always, they used to make fun of Muhammad. That's why he hated them, by the way. Later he discovered, but it was too late. The Jewish, they came to him. They told him, tell us about Prophet Zulqarnain. The donkey, he took the bait. He believed them. He said, yeah, he's a prophet of Allah. And Allah gave him power. This is the prophet you are talking about. He did not know that Zulqarnain, Alexander the Great, have nothing to do with the true God. He's a pagan. He did not know that this guy is a bisexual. He used even to sleep with boys. He did not know that this guy, he himself, he's a gay, which means even men do him. Suddenly, this guy became a messenger of Allah. This is the prophet of God who brought Zulqarnain to be a person sent by God. A person who'd get boom boom. Who men sleep with him. Open my Skype, Abdullah. Are you sure? Okay, Abdullah, I will open Skype just for you. You sound interesting. All right, I'm opening my Skype. Okay, Abdullah, send me a text message, my friend. Hey, Abdullah, send me a text message. Already my Skype is open. I'm waiting for you. Are you there? Oh, this is you? Okay, love my Allah. This is you, Abdullah? Okay. Hello?
Hello?
Yes, my friend, you are live on air. What do you want to say to us?
It's too late and you're streaming still?
But this is the, so you are calling me to say to me it's too late?
No, I want to tell you that you are so obsessed with my prophet. Why?
My friend, I am obsessed with the truth. I want to save the Muslims. So it's imagine if now it is for me 2:13 a.m. in the morning and I save a Muslim from going to hell. Isn't it amazing? Instead of going sleeping and snoring. So let me save you. What do you think about what we are saying?
I know that's amazing if you are really truthful that you are here to save Muslims.
But yeah, why I'm here? Are you paying me to say to talk to you? Did you pay like any?
No, not what I'm saying.
Huh? So why? So what I'm getting from talking to you now? What is the benefit for me?
If that's what you're doing, then it's good for you.
Okay, but let me ask you. As long as we mention this. Shall I charge people to talk to me like now you are calling me, or I should not? I should talk to everybody if I'm a good person.
Yes, you should talk to everyone.
Okay, so why your prophet, he will not talk to anyone unless he pay him?
Okay, we'll get to that, but...
No, we get this to that now. Why your prophet will not talk to anyone unless you pay him?
I don't know. What are you talking about? Show me.
Don't tell me why I'm talking about. I'm asking you, is it true that your prophet will not talk to people, individual, unless they pay him? Yes or no?
I don't know about that.
I don't care if you know or not. I'm asking you, is that good or bad?
I don't know the context. Show me. If I read it, I will know.
I will tell you before, you know, okay, I'm asking you, is that bad or good? I mean, you need to don't know. Is it right that I will not talk to you unless you pay me first?
Look, I cannot say right or wrong.
Why not?
Because there has to be, if my prophet asks for money to talk,
yeah,
then there has to be a reason for it, you know. Because
okay. So what is the reason that I want to talk to you, you will not talk to me, and you are a prophet unless I pay you first?
You know, I think you are lying because Allah said this prophet does not ask you for any money.
Okay, so I'm asking you why you're a prophet then. He will not talk to you or to me or to anyone unless you pay him first.
I don't believe because Allah says my prophet never asked money.
Okay, I'm asking you again. You don't believe, but are you saying to me that this is will be a contradiction?
I have to see what it's about, you know. I have
no problem. I'm asking you again. Are you saying that there's no, you just said no way the prophet will do so. That's mean this is bad.
No, it does not mean it's bad.
But you just said nobody, you know, there was no way the prophet will do that.
No, I said Allah said he doesn't.
Well, you said, I think you are lying. Why you said to me, I'm lying if it's normal to do that? What make you think that this is a lie unless it is an embarrassing?
No, why I'm saying is because.
Read for me chapter 58, verse number 12, and don't waste my time.
What did you say, which chapter? 58 verse 12. Okay, all you who have believed when you privately consult the messenger present before your consultation a charity that is better for you and purer, but if you find not, then indeed. Okay, Allah is not like forcing everybody.
Mm.
You see, Allah is saying, but if you cannot give it, then Allah is forgiving.
Ah, okay, but this is making a sin. Like, you know, when you go now, if you want to talk to the prophet and you don't have anything in your hand, Allah will forgive, you know, Allah is all merciful. He's making them feel guilty. So you have to bring something to him. And you will see here, it says in a private consultation. So you're a prophet. He have a clinic. He opened a business. You want to talk to me in a private, you have to spend some money first.
It is for the sake of Allah.
For the sake of Allah, you have to give it to Muhammad. What sake of Allah? You have to give it to Muhammad.
Allah's religion.
What?
To help Allah's religion, he has to give some money. People.
Why Allah don't give him money? Isn't it Allah is God? Isn't it Allah he can open rivers of gold and silver to Muhammad? Why Allah he need to beg for money, asking Muslims, the poor Muslims, to give Muhammad their money?
Allah can do all of that, but Allah.
No, he cannot. Prove it. Here we go. You just said that Muhammad, he need the money. Let me ask you, did Allah ask the Muslims for a loan?
Yes, that's
okay. Why
that's,
Allah